Hello, guys. I am Shane Davis, 20-year comic book veteran, and I kind of wanted to talk to you guys today about the possibility Marvel Comics is absolutely creatively bankrupt. And once again, we get a variant character. Now, what I mean by a derivative, there's a new event at Marvel Comics called Spider-Man Gang War. This will see Spider-Man, She-Hulk, Miles Morales, Spider-Man, Daredevil, or a variation of Daredevil, I guess. Yes, Shang-Chi, the Deadly Hands of Kung Fu, Luke Cage, Spider-Woman, all together, and some sort of crossover. Now, none of that really matters to the video. None of that really matters, except that companies like to take opportunities like this to have one idea and make it into 8 books. And that's not enough. You can't just make like something like 7-8 books out of one idea. You got to, which is a sign of being creatively bankrupt, you got to have a new book thrown in there, like just throwing a noodle at the wall, see if it sticks. Now, sometimes a character comes out of this and people like the character. In this case, we have, and I kid you not, this is Jackpot. This is Mary Jane as a superhero, because why not? I don't need a new superhero. Why not have a supporting cast, a love interest of Spider-Man now become a superhero, right? It worked so well with Spider-Gwen. Why? Why not just cook up some of that same heat, get that same result? Working in comics for a long time, there's a couple of reasons this happens. You may look at the screen, you'll be like, is this a joke? And it's like, no. Well, that costume looks stupid. It's like, you're absolutely right. It does. It looks absolutely hideous and dumb. And it looks like she rolls numbers like a slot machine on her wrist, and she gets to say, you hit the jackpot. And then she probably punches you in the face. Maybe coins and tokens come out of your mouth. I don't know. I have no idea. I don't even care. I'm not going to drag the creator into this for a reason, but they did hire a female to do this, of course. There's a couple of reasons this is happening, and it will continue to happen. And there is no real big pot of gold at the end of the road of giving Marvel and DC a new character. And this is a problem that they don't know exactly how to maneuver. Major corporations don't want to change the deal. Maybe they don't. It's not that they don't want to. Maybe they can't. Because if they change the deal, like, it just kind of opens up the vault on, we owe everybody so much money because of years of stealing characters and ideas and never paying creatives as they rot in bankruptcy or poverty, you know, or something like that. We as a company can't walk this back. So they have to go forward. So this is a couple of things. One, the apathy of the creator to not want to make a brand new superhero that would stand side by side with Spider-Man. And I understand that. I've been there. I know that. I know that assignment where Marvel says, hey, can you draw this bad guy punching Hulk? And I'm like, you have a design? They're like, no, just make it up. And I'm like, dude, you're paying me for one cover. You think I'm going to make a character for you for a few $100? Do you think I'm going to make Marvel Comics? I had that conversation with an editor. He's like, oh, well, I'll get you a design. It's like, yeah, thank you. Editor never hired me again for a cover. That was the one and only cover. Because I was like, I'm not going to be the guy to design this Hulk bad guy on the cover. Now, that's apathy. That's apathy. That's some of its knowledge, reading around about how creators got screwed out of their creations. And this leaves the company to come up with what I call editorial meeting characters. There's no real creative muscle behind this. This is the derivative. This is when you try to refurbish something, or you try to take two characters and smash together. Maybe you'll come up with a Reese's cup or something like that. I don't know. This reeks of an editorial meeting for a couple of reasons. It's an event. And they're like, well, what's the point of doing an event, sort of, in all these street level character books if we don't just make a new character? But is there a need for this character? And that's the real question. Is there? The answer is yes, in a weird way, because Marvel Comics, they don't really sell a lot of comics. They don't really make a lot of money for Marvel Entertainment. And the less money they make and the less popular their books are, and comic sales are down, comic shops are going over to like Jim Hanley's Universe in New York City. So Marvel Comics and editorial are up under a lot of pressure to develop a new character. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean that character has to be successful, and follow me on this, because Hollywood probably doesn't know what a good idea is. Tons of Marvel movies have been bad ideas, you know, like Eternals. Who thought that was a good idea? Who thought anybody wanted that? They did it anyways. So all Marvel editorial has to do to keep their jobs is huddle together and come up with a idea. Now, this idea could have been there for years. It could have been the leftover, the thing that didn't make it through on the boat in all these Marvel meetings and, you know, their annual get-togethers, the Spider-Man office. Maybe they're like, yeah, let's just do another variation of Venom this time. That Mary Jane jackpot, yeah, don't know. That's not good. And eventually they run out of ideas and then they're like, yeah, that one bad idea we've had for like 9 years. Now's the time. We do need another female character in the Spider-Man ranks. It's too many men swinging around. And Hollywood just looks at like, oh yeah, they made a new idea. Yeah, we don't know. Let's see what people think. And then that's it. I mean, Marvel editorial did their job. The corporation that owns them. They served a purpose, and maybe the purpose isn't making good comics. Maybe the purpose is to somehow come up with a IP that they legally write out own. And to the company, this looks great. Well, we own Mary Jane. Yeah, we're not fighting with anybody over Mary Jane Watson. Yeah, make a character off of her. Does anybody want it? It doesn't matter. But we could make a new superhero. We got this guy over here who really needs a 6-issue miniseries. He's got this brand new character. And whatever, and but the cut is he's gonna want like a nickel every time you sell a Marvel Legends toy. Doesn't sound so great to the corporate bean counter. Why would I give a nickel to a guy for a brand new character every time I sell an action figure when I could make an action figure out of Mary Jane Watson as jackpot that nobody wants? And that's Hollywood accounting, and this is the creative bankruptcy that is Marvel Comics. If you guys will, please look up below, hit like, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications. Also, go check out Axcend. Level up! This is my video game inspired comic book. Three characters go to a video game virtual reality world, and when they log out, they activate as their video game avatars with all the special abilities and adventure happens. If you guys will, go check this out, and I'll catch you guys again with another video.
I dream of a world carefully crafted, beautifully flawed. This is Axcend. In this game of life, there is one thing that determines a victor. A player's ability to grow. A player's ability to evolve. A player's ability to survive. My name is Dog. Choose to play. Choose to upgrade. Choose to level up. Choose to Axcend.